ain't done nothing to him but count this money. Guard Your Girl Boxing, Coffee with Coltrane. First soldier boy ever on Guard Your Girl Boxing. Shout out to the hip hop purists out there. I just thought the single was appropriate due to the news that came out over the weekend. Y'all know what it is. The duffel bag boy. You know, what'd he say? The hockey bag boy, he calls himself. And that's Money, Money, Money Mayweather. Yes, Money Mayweather is back in the sport of boxing where he belongs. Signed to fight Juan Manuel Marquez, July 18th on a pay-per-view card on HBO. They're fighting at a catch weight, I believe 143, 145 or something like that, although it's documented as a welterweight fight. Long story short, the money man is back, you know, coming back for his spot, so take two. You know, we had a crazy weekend. Shout out to the detractors out there. You know, Coltrane hold money may down, so, you know, we're going to be going through this all summer. You know, I ain't budging on that. You know how I feel about the money man, so... You know, we gonna keep it moving on that. So, you know, props to Manny Pacquiao again, you know, for his victory over Ricky the Hitman Hatton. Shout out to the UK. Apologies in order after that destruction. Hope Ricky Hatton is cool, doing well. He needs to fall back, sit on that chicken he done made, you know, and just watch the sport from afar, man. But you know, boxing still goes on, man. Shout out to the casual fans. It was a great time, you know. We enjoyed the company. I'm sure y'all gonna scatter like roaches when the lights come on, cause now we're back to boxing now. So shout out to the GYGB family out there. Y'all know who y'all are. So you know, we got some fights coming up. You know, Coffee with Coltrane every week is promised. We had these big fights. That's why I was put on hiatus, but we back. Shout out to GYGB, Sleep, Big Mike, Docs, Ride or Die. So let's get right into it. The much anticipated that all y'all been craving for is going down this Saturday, and that's, brace yourself now, Hector Camacho Sr. versus Yuri Borikampis. Nah, shout out to Camacho, man. Look, that fight is actually happening now. That's no fluff. Like, Hector Camacho and Yuri Bori is squaring off this weekend. I think they put about a century mark between the two of them, between both of their ages, you know, it probably add up to about the century mark. But we got a light heavyweight fight coming up Saturday. You know, I know a lot of y'all doesn't feel this fight should be happening, and I'm kind of in agreement from a boxing perspective, but from a business perspective, I understand why this fight is going on. Bad Chad Dawson, the light heavyweight champ, recognized as the light heavyweight champion of the world. I know some people don't feel he is because they felt as though he got a gift decision over Glenn Coff Johnson, but he is recognized as the light heavyweight champion of the world. He's fighting on Antonio, the Magic Man Tarver. It's a rematch. You know, Chad is putting his strap on the line on Saturday. First fight was pretty much just Bad Chad putting on a boxing lesson against, in my opinion, one of the most overrated fighters in the sport of boxing, Antonio Tarver, who calls himself the legend killer, but only got one legend on his resume. You know, no disrespect to Glenn Johnson, but he's not considered a legend, you know. So you lost to the other legend you fought was Bernard Hockland. You got spanked 12 straight rounds, homie. So I don't know where you get that legend killer stuff from. And whenever that fight was, 5, 6, 7 months ago, when you fought the up and coming young Bad Chad Dawson, you know, you was rocking your earmuffs the whole fight, like, you know, it was a snowstorm. So, the first fight, pretty much, like I said, Chad putting his work on. You know, Chad, you know, throw those 6-7 piece combos. You know, he liked to go backwards as he liked to box. You know, he throw feints. You know, he got good head movement. He clip his shoulder real nice. I mean, the dude just do everything a boxer is supposed to be. His footwork is always in a proper place. You know, he had a problem with right hands early on in his career. You know, and most noticeable was the Tomas Adamek fight when Adamek was at light heavyweight and he caught Chad. And I think Chad got caught and used to get caught a lot for admiring his work. You know what I'm saying? Like, he'd be in the mix and he's so sharp and so nasty with it. Sometimes you know, you get caught. Like, oh, look at that move I just did. I mean, real quick. And just like that, boom, you get caught. And he got caught with a right hand, got put on his arse. Shout out to the UK. But he got up, weathered the storm, and put on a boxing lesson. And now we see, you know, how good Chad is now that Adam Mack is in cruiserweight, you know, pretty much, you know, ruling that division. You know what I mean? Although, you know, once watching the Steve Cunningham fight again, I did give Cunningham the fight, and I know what y'all are going to say. You're only saying it because that's your homie. No, I'm saying it because I watched the fight again, and Steve won that fight, just like I thought Juan Manuel Marquez won both Pacquiao fights. So, and I don't have no relationship with Juan Manuel Marquez, so, but that's a whole nother story. Yeah, so the rematch is happening because of this bottom line. Bad Chad Dawson is with HBO now. You know, much as we love Showtime, they put on a great fight. You know, they money looking funny and the like compared to HBO. The monumental fights go down on HBO, as we saw this weekend and many other fights. I don't even know the last time Showtime even put on a pay-per-view card. So if you want to get that, you want to get that chicken fried right, you go to HBO. So Chad is on HBO. Most casuals know who Tarver is. So it's somewhat of a selling fight for Chad Dawson to the general public. And it's a coming out party for Chad on their network. So, you know, this is, like I said, this is just a fight to set Chad up for some future things later. So how I see the fight going, just like the first one. You know, I just see Chad just outboxing him. You remember in the first fight, Chad pretty much put on a boxing masterpiece for 12 straight rounds. He took a few rounds off and He got caught rocking the headphones a few times, but he kind of like laughed at Tarver to take a round. He's like, I'm going to stand right here in front of you, muff up, and you're not going to be able to touch me. Then after that, I forget what round it was. It was a couple, like right after the next round, he came out throwing 6-7-piece combos to Tarver. Too fast, too elusive, too young, too slippery, too hungry. After this fight, maybe this will be the last we'll see Antonio Tarver, the suspect legend killer, as he like to call himself, and then we can see Bad Chad Dawson blossom on. But here's the problem for Chad Dawson. Where that money at is in 168 pound weight limit. Now, at light heavyweight, it's not nothing really up there for him, you know, if he's looking to, you know, fight the best and cash out, you know. You know, you still got Bernard Hopkins out there who was rumored in the news to as a potential fight with Carl Froch. And it's funny how Jermaine, I'm getting to that. Bernard is, you know, keeping his career moving at the expense of Jermaine Teller. It's funny how that stuff happens. But, you're like, you beat Kelly Pavlik, and now he wants Carl Froch just to stick it, and he beat Winky Wright. All these people, either Jermaine Teller lost or like, you know, and he drew with Winky Wright, but most people thought Winky won. But Bernard is sticking it to Jermaine Teller, and he lives to fight another day. Looks like he might have found his opponent. And that fight is a shutout. I know Nottingham, you know, if y'all watching this video, if y'all watch other boxing. No, I'm just kidding. I know we got some good boxing fans in Nottingham. But if y'all watching this, you know, it's nothing personal. You know, a lot of great fighters lost to Bernard Hopkins. And it's just a total mismatch. He comes straight forward. That's like the worst style for Bernard's opponent. But that's it, man. So I'm picking Bad Chad Dawson to win this fight. I got a real good show coming up, and we're gonna do my certified G all Mexican list. You don't want to miss this show. You know, we talking about the likes of Salvatore Sanchez, Julio Cesar Chavez, you know, Marco Antonio Barrera might show up on my list. I don't know. We going deep into the archives. You know, because the Mexicans gave so much to this beautiful sport of boxing. So I felt as though it was time to pay some homage. So the top 5, 10, whatever, y'all throw some names at me. And we're going to compile a list. It's COFFE with Coltrane, Guard Your Girl Boxing, number one boxing show on this here dial. We love everybody out there for supporting us, even the haters.